In recent decades, stealth aircraft have played a central role in U.S. military strategy, offering the ability to penetrate defended airspace with minimal risk of detection. However, China's advancements in airborne radar technology, particularly in the form of its KJ-2000 and the next-generation KJ-3000, are challenging the assumptions that have long underpinned American aerial dominance. These aircraft are not simply tools of surveillance. They are becoming command and control hubs capable of neutralizing the very advantage stealth platforms were designed to maintain. The KJ-2000, developed in the early 2000s, initially emerged from a failed partnership between China and Israel. Under U.S. pressure, Israel canceled the transfer of its Falcon airborne radar system. What China received instead was a stripped-down IL-76 airframe, returned without its core electronic suite. This setback, however, marked the beginning of a determined domestic effort that would eventually produce one of the most formidable early warning aircraft in Asia. By 2005, China had outfitted the once-empty airframe with indigenously developed phased array radar panels. Unlike the mechanically scanning rotodomes used on older platforms such as the American E-3 Sentry, the KJ-2000's three fixed radar arrays provided continuous, high-speed scanning with coverage across the entire 360 degrees. This approach allowed radar refresh rates roughly 30 times faster than traditional systems, significantly improving tracking performance against fast-moving targets. The operational significance of this capability became evident during live-fire exercises and simulations. During one test in the northwestern region of China in 2009, a KJ-2000 reportedly tracked a target aircraft simulating an F-22 Raptor at a distance of nearly 300 kilometers. Within 90 seconds, it relayed targeting data to a J-10 fighter, which then executed a simulated missile launch. The exercise demonstrated not only detection, but effective integration into an airborne kill chain. What gives the KJ-2000 its edge in anti-stealth detection is not merely raw radar power, but its use of low-frequency bands such as L-band radar, which are less affected by stealth coatings optimized for higher frequencies. While fifth-generation fighters like the F-22 boast radar cross-sections of as little as 0.01 square meters under ideal conditions, operational factors, such as open weapon bays, engine heat, or even altitude, can dramatically increase their detectability. Chinese sources claim that the effective radar cross-section of an F-22 can expand to between 3 and 5 square meters when observed by airborne early warning systems at high altitude. In simpler terms, this makes the aircraft appear as large on radar as a conventional fourth-generation fighter. The implication is profound. Stealth does not equal invisibility. If confirmed, such capabilities would allow even older Chinese fighters, when cued by a KJ-2000, to engage stealth targets previously thought untouchable. The KJ-2000's radar can refresh every 0.3 seconds, a significant improvement over traditional airborne platforms that take 10 seconds or more to complete a full scan. In high-speed aerial combat, this temporal advantage can be the difference between maintaining a lock or losing track of a target entirely. The system also employs advanced clutter suppression, allowing it to detect low-flying cruise missiles by filtering out radar noise from ground reflections. The ability to operate in a dense electronic environment has also been strengthened by algorithms that adapt in real time to environmental conditions. These space-time adaptive techniques, paired with a cooling system designed to support continuous phased array operation, have allowed China's airborne radars to function more reliably and with higher resolution than many analysts expected. China's airborne surveillance network has not stopped at the KJ-2000. In the years since its introduction, newer platforms like the KJ-500 and KJ-600 have emerged, providing greater coverage and integration with naval forces. The latest development, the KJ-3000, may represent the most significant leap yet. Built on a domestically produced Y-20B platform, the KJ-3000 features a new generation of radar powered by gallium nitride-based transmitters. This material allows for increased power density, reportedly up to 300% higher than traditional components, and improved thermal performance. Gallium nitride radar systems are not merely smaller and more efficient, they can also support multiple frequency bands simultaneously. The KJ-3000's radar suite reportedly includes both S-band and ultra-high frequency UHF capabilities. While S-band radars are suitable for general tracking of conventional aircraft and missiles, UHF bands are particularly effective against stealth targets, whose coatings and shaping are optimized to reduce visibility in higher frequency bands. Combined with quantum radar prototypes under testing, the KJ-3000 is designed to operate as a comprehensive airspace management system. Chinese reports claim it can detect even the B-21 Raider, the United States' next-generation stealth bomber, at distances of up to 800 kilometers. Although such claims remain unverified, they reflect the growing ambition behind China's airborne surveillance architecture. One of the more strategic implications lies in the reported range and endurance of these aircraft. With aerial refueling capability and an improved WS-20 turbofan engine, the KJ-3000 is said to have a range exceeding 8,000 kilometers and an operational endurance close to 24 hours. Four of these aircraft operating in rotation could provide persistent surveillance coverage over the Western Pacific, extending China's sky eye well beyond the first island chain. These developments have reportedly had a tangible impact on the operational tempo of U.S. forces. By mid-2025, the number of instances in which U.S. F-35 aircraft were detected while operating near the East China Sea had tripled. American reconnaissance flights have been reduced in frequency as a result of the heightened detection risk, according to open-source analysis. The U.S. military still awaiting delivery of its next-generation early warning aircraft, not expected until 2032, now faces a capability gap. It is not only detection that matters, it is what happens next. The KJ-3000's real-time data links allow it to coordinate large numbers of fighters, missiles, and ground-based air defenses. In one exercise, a KJ-2000 reportedly controlled as many as 12 fighter formations, effectively creating a multi-layered engagement strategy designed to overwhelm even the most advanced aircraft. When combined with long-range air-to-air missiles like the PL-17, which has an estimated range of 400 kilometers, non-stealth platforms like the J-16 can potentially engage stealth targets with data provided by an early warning aircraft. The strategic concern is not just technological, but systemic. China's model emphasizes the integration of sensors, platforms, and weapons into a seamless network, allowing inferior individual assets to outperform superior ones when used as part of a coordinated system. In this view, even if the F-22 remains a superior airframe, it becomes increasingly vulnerable when operating in isolation or without timely support. Perhaps most telling is how the trajectory of China's early warning aircraft reflects broader trends in its military modernization. What began as a setback in 1999 has evolved into an area of relative strength. A once-empty IL-76 airframe has become the foundation of an indigenous capability that now threatens to upend long-standing assumptions about air power in the Asia-Pacific region. The development of these systems also serves a deterrent function. Knowing that stealth aircraft may be detected and targeted well before they reach their intended area of operation adds complexity to any potential air campaign. U.S. military planners now must account for a world in which invisibility is increasingly an illusion. As radar technology continues to evolve, with artificial intelligence, quantum sensing, and improved materials, the advantage may tilt further toward those who prioritize systemic integration and information dominance. For now, China appears to have seized the lead in this domain, and its early warning aircraft are no longer simply eyes in the sky. They are becoming the brains of an aerial network designed to see, track, and strike in a battle space where stealth is no longer safe.